Let's start our new chapter is training in sports. The word training is not a new word. Training means the process of preparation for some task. Task is fitness and conditioning for sports and games. It is only due to that this term is mostly used in sports and games. So it is called sports training. Sports training is the main component and the basic form of preparing the sportsman. It is a systematically planned preparation with the help of various exercises. Already you all have known about components of physical fitness. Components of physical fitness are strength, speed, endurance, flexibility, and coordinative abilities. These all the components of physical fitness can be improved by the help of sports training. In this text, first we discussed about strength. Simply we can say that strength is the ability of muscles to overcome resistance. Strength is the ability of the muscles to overcome resistance. Strength is very essential element or components of physical fitness. Okay. According to Barrow and Maggie's opinion, they are defined that strength is the capacity of the whole body or of any of its parts to exert force. You can be select any one of the definitions. Okay. Next subtopic is types of strength. There are two types, isotonic strength and isometric strength. Different types of sports require different types of strength. So, for better understanding, strength can be divided into the following types. Strength mainly divided into two types, static strength or isometric strength. Next one is dynamic strength or isotonic strength. Here, dynamic strength or isotonic strength again divided into three types. Maximum strength, explosive strength, strength endurance. Here, first we discuss about isotonic strength or dynamic strength. Dynamic strength or isotonic strength is very essential to improve strength because it has some importance because it is related to the movements. In pull-ups and push-ups, we require dynamic strength. In performing such workout, there is a diminishing tendency in dynamic strength, and as a result, after some time, muscles refuse to do work. At this juncture, man is not able to do even one extra pull-ups or push-ups. Movements are clearly visible when someone uses dynamic strength. In each sports movement, strength appears in a different form. Generally, dynamic strength can be divided into three parts: maximum strength, explosive strength, strength endurance. Dynamic strength, also known as isotonic strength. Okay, clear? Sir, all the movements we can be visible. Okay. Okay, first one is maximum strength. It is the ability to act against maximum resistance. Maximum strength is not usually used in majority of sports. It is usually used in those sports in which very heavy resistance have to be tackled. Example, weightlifting, shot put, hammer throw, discus throw, javelin throw. Maximum strength, ability to act against maximum resistance. Okay. Examples, hammer throw, discus throw, javelin throw. Following activities, we need use maximum strength. Okay. Second one is explosive strength. Explosive strength can be defined as the ability to overcome resistance with high speed. Explosive strength can be defined as the ability to overcome resistance with high speed. It is a combination of strength and speed abilities. Explosive strength is generally used in sprint events, weightlifting, shot put, hammer throw, javelin throw, discus throw, long jump, high jump, triple jump, etc. That's why it is called explosive power. because up to some extent it is also used in endurance events, especially in the start and spurt phases. In above mentioned sports, this force is applied just like an explosion. Those explosions, so it is called explosive power, explosive strength or explosive power. Again, I'll define explosive strength. Explosive strength can be defined as the ability to overcome resistance with high speed. Okay. And third one is strength endurance. Strength endurance is the combination of strength and endurance abilities. Strength endurance can be defined as the ability to overcome resistance under the condition of fatigue. It can be form of static or dynamic strength depending on the fact whether the movement is static or dynamic. Okay. Strength endurance is commonly used in long distance races, swimming, road cycling, etc. So it can be alluded that strength endurance is usually applied in most of the sports. Strength endurance is used in most of the sports. It's a combination of strength and endurance. How to define strength endurance? It can be defined as ability to overcome resistance under the condition of fatigue. Examples: long distance races, swimming, etc. And second term is static strength or isometric strength. Static strength is also called isometric strength. It is the ability to muscles to act against resistance. Static strength is also called isometric strength. It is the ability of muscles to act against resistance. Static strength can be measured by dynamometer. Static strength can be measured by dynamometer. This type of strength is not seen indirectly. Static strength is not usually applied in sports, but in weightlifting it is applied in some phases. Okay. What are the main difference between dynamic and static strength? Dynamic strength we can be seen the movements. In the case of static strength, we can't see the movements. That is the main differences. Okay. Now, how to improve strength with the help of physical training? If you want to improve strength, some of the methods are given in the text. There are three methods: isometric exercises, isotonic exercise, and isokinetic exercise. Okay. First method is isometric exercises. Already we know about the features of isometric exercises. That means isometric exercises are those exercises which are not visible. There are no direct movements. That means there are no direct movements. Hence they cannot be observed. In these exercises work is performed, but it is not seen directly. In these exercises, a group of muscles carry out tension against the other group of muscles. When these exercises are done, muscles do not change their length. They remain fixed or constant. We can say that work is done during these exercises, but scientifically we cannot say that work is done. For example, if we push a concrete wall, what will happen? We will be unable to move it from its place. Yes? So we should not consider it as a work. Our muscle exert force while pushing a wall, but we see that work is not done. That is the difference. When we do these exercises, expenditure of energy is a usual phenomenon. Sometimes temperature may increase while performing these exercises. If we perform these exercises regularly, muscles will be changed in relation to size and shape. These exercises are used for the development of strength. The strength improved through isometric exercise is usually not of much value of sports. These exercises need less time and can be performed anywhere because no need of any equipments. That is the main important. Okay. These exercises are valuable for rehabilitation purpose. Isometric exercises are mainly important for rehabilitation purposes. These exercises can be done by a person who is injured. Isometric exercise should not be performed by children and untrained persons, because these are isometric exercises are mainly various types of stretching exercises. These exercises should be done with proper procedure, otherwise it will get any negative results. So these all the exercises cannot do children and untrained persons. Okay, these are the features of isometric exercises. We can be improved strength, but it will take some more time for to improving strength. Okay, and second method is isotonic exercises. Isotonic exercises are those exercises in which movements can be seen directly. Work is done in these exercises. Isotonic exercises tone up the muscles. Muscles become flexible. Length of the muscles can be increased by isotonic exercises. These are the main features of isotonic exercises. Especially in the field of physical activities, isotonic exercises are much values in the values. These are the best for strength development. The examples for isotonic exercises are calisthenics exercises, running, jumping on the spot, weight training exercises. Exercises with the medicine ball are the best examples for isotonic exercises. Another important features of isotonic exercises are these all the exercises can be done with or without apparatus. This is a very important to improve our get fastest performance, fastest enhanced performance in the exercise, the form of isotonic exercises. And third one is isokinetic exercises. Isokinetic exercises are performed on specially designed machines. Very important point is isokinetic exercises are performed on specially designed machines. Maybe asking one more questions. These exercises were developed by Perrin in 1968. This also you should remember. It's developed by Perrin in the year of 1968. These exercises involve a specific type of muscle contraction which is usually not applicable in sports and games, except in water sports like rowing and swimming. Most of the sports, isokinetic exercises is not needed. Especially it should be needed for water sports like rowing and swimming. Okay, in isotonic exercise, main difference of isotonic and isokinetic exercises are isotonic exercises are contraction of muscles applies maximal forces only a particular angle of its range of movements, at a particular angle of its range of movement, whereas in isokinetic exercises are contraction of muscles applies maximal force throughout the complete range of movement. That is the main difference between isotonic and isokinetic. According to the individual's capacity, the speed of contraction can be adjusted. The individual who performs isokinetic exercise on machine should keep in his mind that he has to apply his force throughout the range of movement by fixing the number of repetition and by reducing or increasing the speed. The isokinetic exercise can be used effectively for the development of strength. With the help of these exercises, explosive strength and strength endurance can be improved. With the help of isokinetic exercise, explosive strength and strength endurance can be improved.